how to make an API that lists all the images which we want. Like, for example, we are going to build a website where we are going to show all the office space images fetched from Unsplash using Unsplash API, but we do not want to read Unsplash documentation. It is long and it gets confusing. So the quickest way to build your app is using a no-code tool. For that, we are going to use NoCodeAPI, which allows us to search all these photos, to list these photos, to get a random photo, to get a photo statistics, and all these methods. These are listed over here. For that, we are going to build our NoCodeAPI, and after that, we are going to use a download.com to build our website. To activate your Unsplash NoCodeAPI, we are going to click on Set Up This API. Click here. And you will land in your dashboard of NoCode API. Click on the View Marketplace button. Go for Unsplash. Click Activate. And here we are going to create a new Unsplash API. We are going to give it a name. It's Demo App. And here we are going to give it an access key. The access key, we can find it here. If we click here, we will land at API Applications of Unsplash. You will need to log in with your account. And here you are going to click on New Application. After that, agree to all the guidelines and terms, accept their terms, and say office space. For example, we are going to fetch office space ideas. Click Create Application and go down. You can find your access key over here. Copy it to your clipboard and paste it over here. Once you do that, click Create. And next, to make sure that our endpoint is functional, we are going to open the playground and search for photos and say office space. Click Execute. Once you execute, you are going to see a response message of 200, and it is going to give us a response body where our results are embedded in JSON, and the key where our results are lying is the results array. So we are going to download it. Once we have downloaded, we are going to open it and see for ourselves if the result is formatted properly. This is the results array where all is data located. We are going to get the regular link to the image here, and we are going to get the username and the location of the image where it was taken, and we are going to show it on a website using a website builder called as Adalo. So for building a website builder, we are going to go to app.adalo.com and we are going to click a create new app. We are going to use desktop web app. Click next. We are going to select a blank canvas. Click next and say this is office spaces and click create. After that, we are going to delete all these screens to make sure that we have nothing on screen, and we are going to add a new blank screen, and we are going to say that it is a list of images and say office images and click create screen. Once it has been created, delete the result item, increase the space where we want to show these images, and increase the number of the images which we want to see for ourselves. And next, we are going to connect our database so that all these images are fetched from Unsplash, but we do not want to reach this documentation. We are just going to use the NoCodeAPI endpoint which we just created, and we are going to create our own collection for linking our website builder with Unsplash images. So for that, we are going to copy this endpoint here at NoCodeAPI dashboard. Click Add Collection, give it a name, Office Images. Base URL is this, and we're going to add a header. We're going to say it is content type text HTML. Press Done, click Next, get all. Here we're going to use the playground endpoint which we just made over here. Copy it. Paste it over here And in the results key, is the results array nested under some key? Yes, we have seen that it is nested in results key, and press done. After that, click next and press run test. Okay, the test was successful. We can now create this collection and connect it with the website builder. Now to connect these images with our data, we are going to say that we are going to use this collection, collection which we just created, office images. It is placed over here, office images. And in office images, we are going to say that these images are our URL, and this URL is inside this object, and it is urls.regular. So we have connected our URL, and next we are going to see if it is working okay or not. All right. Our website has been loaded and it is showing us all these images of office spaces, and we can see that these are a little compressed, these are too small, so these should be towards the edges a little, and we want to show the name of the photographer and we want to show his location. For that, we are going to increase the size of this screen according to our requirement, and we are going to say that the width of the screen is 1500, and we are going to elongate the nav bar here. We are going to stretch to the end, and we are going to increase the size until it is in the middle. And next, we are going to update the text on each image. The title is not the ID, it is the name of the photographer. It is in username, and we are going to subtitle, change it to the location of the user. So the location of the subtitle is below the title, and press done. So after that, we are going to run this link again, and we are going to see the name of the photographer. James McDonald, he took this picture in UK, Jonna Ardronson from Bali, Florida, North Carolina. So this is how you can show all the images using your backend through NoCode API, and there are numerous ways through which you can fetch your data from any third-party app using NoCode API tools. So this is the way which you can use to build your own custom apps without writing any line of code. If you have any queries or if you're confused about any method listed over here, you can click this support button, reach us, and we will be glad to help you out. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.